Rod Serling. You're listening to The Zero Hour. Rest your eyes. Exercise your imagination. Today, Keith Walker's story of the ultimate revenge. Scream of the Hawk. Starring Mel Tormé. In a Mutual Broadcasting System presentation of The Zero Hour.
Brought to you by the makers of General Motors Parts, by the State Farm Insurance Company, by Dial Soap, and by the makers of Contact on Mutual Radio.
Picture, if you will, a 20th century man burdened with the values of a 19th century pioneer. Judd Colby is just such a man, faced with the encroaching tide of glass and concrete progress. This is a man out of time, out of step with today. Or is he? Join us now for Scream of the Hawk.
All right, Charlie, get on that track. Get over to Section 4. But tell them to clear away those remaining trees. And don't take any more crap from the Gorkins. All right, get that section clear.
Now, hold up a minute.
I can tell you, but he's got me running around like a chicken with his head
off. The boss says do, you do, babe. Now, let's you and I make like tank commanders. Hustle over to Section 4.
Here they come! Remember all the trees! Get that up here!
Hey, Tom! Put the rifle away!
You and you get in front of the tree! You two get up into the bushes! Mom and Helen, sit down and press there!
Miranda, sure as hell is going to run us over.
Come on, you people. Get the hell out of there. Our orders are to clear this land, and we're going to do it.
Shut up! Pull it out your ear! Land, baby!
One of them has a rifle.
Move the cat forward, Hal.
Let it go, sir, and I'll blow somebody's head off.
Damn it, Tom, you'll have the law on us.
Charlie, you drive it. I ain't doing another foot.
That's it.
Yeah, get out of here. Yellow hat means yellow streak. All right. Well, just listen for a minute.
Okay, everybody pipe down. Now, what do you want, Charlie?
Be reasonable, Murray. Now, take these folks and get the hell on home. We got to clear this area.
Charlie, you're a sellout. Put on a yellow hard hat and your head gets hot.
Yeah. Now, wait a minute. It's been explained a million times to everybody. This is progress. The people around here got to have a place to buy food and clothes and, you know. So we're putting up a shopping center. Oh.
Charlie, why don't you ask the people if it's for the people? Yeah. Well, we're people. And we don't want these New England hills all tore up.
Murray, you people, now, what's wrong with what's happening?
Murray, let me.
Yeah, go ahead.
I'll tell you what's wrong, Charlie Daniels. Pack up and get out.
Right, yeah, right.
We don't want your kind of concrete progress.
That's right, Helen, yeah. You're right.
We want green grass and trees for our kids.
You got it, Helen.
Don't fire again, Tom. At least you frightened him away.
Yeah. Somebody get a doctor.
Yeah. What's that thing?
It was a hawk. I think it was a hawk.
You're right, Helen.
Charlie. Charlie, can you hear me?
Murray. I can't see. I can't.
Holy mother. The hawk killed him.
There, easy, Right back in your cage. That's it.
Judd? You in there? Hello?
Myra, I'll meet you in the house.
Right. Coffee Perks in 5. Hi, this is Myra Colby. Any messages? Uh-huh. Sure. Oh, Judd, don't! Oh, no, I didn't mean you, operator. Right, thank you.
Did I scare you, honey? I'm sorry. Now, what brings my love home so early in the evening? I thought you had a meeting.
Oh, I did, but the Ladies' Guild is dull, dull, dull.
I know what you mean. Hey, listen, I'm coffee-starved. Where's that promised brew, huh?
10 years of marriage. Where's my promised kiss? Getting tired of this old lined woman?
Never tired. Come here.
No, you don't. Not if I have to prompt.
By God, you're a slippery one, lady.
Judd, give me a serious moment, okay?
Yeah, okay.
Did you work something out with Hank Tye about our land near the shopping center?
No, and I don't intend to. The land stays intact as long as I'm around to hold onto it.
My darling hardhead. Judd, don't you realize this is the decade of neon progress? Besides, it's just a few acres, and we've got nearly 1,000. Sell it and keep the peace in Tandem County.
Now, look, Myra, I don't give a damn about the peace, and there are a lot of people that feel the same way. They're just not going to destroy this land.
Are we expecting company?
Maybe. I'll take a look. I was afraid of that.
What?
Police. Lieutenant Owens and friend. Myra, you see them at the door. Now, if they should ask about me, tell them I'm gone.
Judd, what's wrong? Why should I lie to Dan Owens?
Because, my sweet one, I had a man killed today.
Judd!
Look, I'll explain later. Just answer the door.
Where are you going?
The river cabin. Now, when they leave, bring the birds and some supplies for a couple of days, will you?
I don't understand, Judd.
Myra, please just trust me for now, okay?
Oh, okay. Judd, I love you. Coming!
Hello, Myra. Is Judd around?
Oh, Dan. Sergeant. No, Judd's not here.
Well, it's kind of important and official, Myra. Mind if we sort of look around?
Dan, do you have a warrant?
Well, I didn't think that would be necessary, seeing as how we've known each other a long time.
Not officially, we haven't. So unless you've got the warrant, just turn around and drive back to town.
Just one question. Do you know if Judd had the hacks out hunting today?
I don't know. I was at a meeting until a while ago.
Charlie Daniels was killed. Witnesses say that he was deliberately attacked by a hawk. Maybe Judd's.
And maybe Wild, Lieutenant.
Well, I certainly hope so. That's why we want to talk with Judd. It could happen again, and your husband's the only one in the county that knows about them.
Well, I'll tell him to call you. Good night.
Hey, the lights are going out. She could be leaving.
What makes you think Myra Colby is lying?
Sort of a hunch. A lot of bad feeling between the Colbys and the construction company. Look, she's using their Jeep. Let's follow up.
So, you see, Myra, I no longer believe I had a choice. Something drastic had to be done, so I trained the hawks to attack the color of the hard hats.
Then you didn't really think that Dot would kill. Just frightened.
That's right, but I'm not sorry now. Maybe they learned a lesson. They'll pack up and leave, huh?
How do you expect to come out of all this?
I don't know. Maybe I won't. I can't stand by and let them destroy land I've worked my whole life for.
I am afraid that you will have to, Judd.
Lieutenant, how did you get in?
Sorry, Myra, through the bedroom window. Judd, both the sergeant and I heard what you said and...
Drop the guns, Dan. Drop them. Sergeant, you too. Do it slowly.
What are you talking about?
Both the hawks are unchained on their perch. Now, if I motion, they'll attack you. And I have no quarrel with you.
I don't believe him, Lieutenant.
But I do, Sergeant. Judd here has trained birds all his life.
Thank you. Myra packed me some food. Look, Dan, I've got a message for you to deliver to Hank Tye. Now, you tell him that the minute construction ceases, I'll stop the birds. Otherwise, every time he moves a tractor, someone dies.
Judd, you mustn't do this, please.
As I said, my love, I've no choices left.
It's been 2 weeks I've had this equipment idle. New York is all over my butt.
We've been doing what we can, but Judd Colby knows these hills, and we can't find him.
Oh, you think he's taken off? Maybe it's safe to start again?
Well, that's your decision, Ty. We'll give you what protection we can. Now, I've got four men with rifles scattered around. If the birds come, there's a good chance we'll get them.
Well, I'm going to do just that. First thing tomorrow. That is, if New York says so.
Myra, wake up.
Huh? Oh, Judd, is that you?
Yeah, well, I can't stay long. I came across Harry Finley tonight up near River Line. He told me they intend to start work again tomorrow morning.
Judd, you mustn't do any more. This is not a fight you can win.
Well, maybe not, but it is my fight, and I must do what I believe is right.
I can't let you. I've been filled with so many conflicting thoughts these past 2 weeks. My darling, you are wrong. It's just too late to be a pioneer protecting your land against attack. It's the 20th century and...
Stop! Look, I know what you're saying, but somebody's got to set an example for others to follow. They're far worse than I. They kill the land, and with it die the animals as well as people.
Judd, stay with me tonight. Tomorrow, I'll go to the bank and withdraw our money.
You know, you were right when you said this was the 20th century. This is the century for the destruction of the land, but I'll make you one promise. If they do not start tomorrow, if they truly believe that the Hawks will come, if they pack up to move, then we'll deed the land to the state and go away.
What makes you think they'll change their minds?
I talked with Hank Tye tonight. Now he's a believer.
I know, Mr. Fair, but he was here just a little while ago. He threatened us again. Plus, we've been getting all sorts of petitions. It's possible not one person will come out here.
Tye, the board met tonight. And we think it was a fluke, that gang boss getting killed.
I don't agree. Colby knows his hawks.
Now listen, Ty, you're a very minor stockholder in this venture. And you still take orders. Unless you want out.
No, sir, but I don't want to get killed, neither.
Then start in the morning. That's the decision here in New York. Do I make myself clear, Ty?
Yes, sir. You do. Come in.
Can you spare a minute, Mr. Ty?
Myra Colby. Surprised to see you here.
I'm surprised to see you've started work again.
Should I be flattered by a visit from the enemy camp?
You're a fool to ignore my husband's warning.
Is that an admission you'd care to repeat to the cops?
I've come because I believe both you and my husband to be wrong in this. But whatever I feel, I can't stand by and let someone else be killed.
Damn, no one.
Ty, we shot one of the hawks.
Good. So your husband kept his word.
I'm afraid so.
Ty, I think that may be the end of your problems. Mrs. Colby, what are you doing here?
Threatening me?
Not threatening, Lieutenant. I came to ask that he stop. That's all.
Well, too late now, Mrs. Colby. We killed the hawk.
My husband has another, Mr. Ty.
Mrs. Colby, get back to the trailer!
That's the bird's going for the crane operator. In the crane! Watch her! Watch her! The load's letting go!
Mrs. Colby, get away! Oh, my God, Ty. Help me get this timber off her!
Myra!
Hold your fire! Hi, it looks like she might be alive. I'll go get some help and check on Judd. May I come in, Myra?
Yes, please.
I was near the hospital, so I thought I'd drop by. I'm sorry about Judd, Myra. Truly, truly sorry.
I know. Thank you.
Is it true you've decided to deed the land over to the state?
Yes. They've promised to turn it into a park.
But why? I mean, surely with the construction people gone...
Oh, they had nothing to do with it. I think it's what Judd would have wanted. To protect the land.
Maybe, but... I thought the construction people were very decent to pull out.
Oh, Dan. Believe me, they didn't do it out of the goodness of their hearts. They left because a man died on their precious ground, and they know no one would ever want to come to a shopping center with a ghost. Judd fought for what he believed in. That much we've learned from him.
I'm Rod Serling. Close your eyes, exercise your imagination, and join us again on our next presentation of The Zero Hour.
Scream of the Hawk is an original radio drama by Keith Walker. Mel Tormé was heard as Judd Colby. Featured in the cast were Peggy Walton, Luke Krugman, Bill Keane, Robert Easton, and Peggy Weber. Zero Hour, created by J.M. Colis, directed by Don Hills, is produced in Hollywood. With Mutual Broadcasting System by Radio Productions Incorporated. Music composed and conducted by Stanley D. Hoffman. Rochelle Sherman, associate producer. This has been a presentation of the Mutual Broadcasting System.